Rais alikuwa anapendwa. I can testify that Chumasi alikuwa anapendwa. So sijui ni wape sorry fupi tu ya mambo yalivyotokea. Manake whatever happened imekuwa ni kitu very sudden. Because Masi alikuwa studio mwisho on Thursday na akafanya show yake kama kawaida. On Friday alikuwa na appointment ya daktari, so hakuingia show. So alipata kwenda kumwona daktari hiyo siku, but everything was okay. At that point it was just an appointment, there was nothing. But this happened on Saturday, that is when everything started. But it's been a journey. Ukiona Masi anatembea, ukiona Masi kwa road shows, ana interact na watu kila mahali. For like 2 years, she's been ailing inside, yet amekuwa tu akismile na nyinyi, akifanya show yake, kuentertain, kuinform, hiyo yote, yet she was ailing. But Masi ni fighter. Despite that, all that, in fact, nilikuwa nasema kwa hiyo theater Masi angekuwa hakuwa amegandishwa, she couldn't have agreed kwenda, because Masi is a fighter. So what happened is, a while back, Masi was diagnosed na kuwa na blood clots kwa abdomen, like kwa tumbo, you know. Na zilikuwa severe. She had to be admitted at Nairobi Hospital for some few days. And akaanza medication hapo. So tumekuwa tukiendelea na medication wenyewe. Kama kuna madaktari hapa wanajua treating blood clots, ni ugonjwa ina take time. It takes time to kuzitreat. So she has been on medication for ile sana sana ilianza on December last year 2023 ikiisha. And three months down the line, Masi akajipata she was expecting. And being expectant with her condition, it was always a risk. It was always a risk. And because there were more issues than just the blood clots, we've gone a period of about 8 years. Tumeandamana. So when Masi found she was expectant, she took the risk to keep the baby. And we went as far as we can to find the best doctors who gave us hope. Na wakatuambia, despite the, you know, the challenges, it was possible to carry the baby full time. But it was always going to be a lot of work. So we knew that from the beginning. So tuliambiwa when we crossed the third month, ni kama tumetoboa, because everything was looking good. For the past 5 months, because Masi's pregnancy was 5 months by the time of her demise, we've been in and out of hospital. Most of you ladies know that when you're expectant, you need to go to the clinic and you know, check the baby, check the mother, and at most, by the time of birth, the most number of ultrasounds someone can have is about 2 or 3. But in a period of 5 months, we had done 16 ultrasounds because it was always a risky pregnancy, and Mercy could go sometimes thrice a week to see the doctor. And every time we saw a doctor, the first thing is to check whether the baby is all right. And there's no two ways about it. So every time there had to be an ultrasound. Doctors in the house knows that treating blood clots and tails using the blood thinners, and Mercy's blood clots were unique because they were inside the body, because most of the time people with blood clots ujipata kwa miguu ama kwa mikono, and rarely inside the body, you know, but inside body parts. But Mercy's, and they were severe, they are all over. If I could show you the scans that were done, the CT scans, they were like all over the abdomen and the back part. So they were severe, and Mercy used to take a lot of medicine. I even became a doctor because I used to be the one who used to inject her medicine every evening at Kitoka Kazi. So it's been a journey, but we always thought we were in control. The doctors give us hope every time. We are saying everything is okay. So until last Saturday, Mercy woke up in good mood. She was supposed to attend a wedding of a dear friend. I don't know if she's here, but Fortune Mekali. And she even had dressed to go to the wedding. But I realized she was in pain. She was like forcing herself, and I talked her out of it. And it didn't take long before things went south, and it became an emergency. We had to go to the hospital. Fortunately, she was done an ultrasound, kama kawaida, and the baby was okay. But she was bleeding. And that was a big problem. So doctor took care of her. Unfortunately, we went home with her. So after that, Sunday was quiet, and Monday was the best day. That day, Mercy didn't go to work, neither did I. Tulishinda tu kwa nyumba, in fact, tulishinda tu kwa bed on Monday. And everything, even the bleeding had, you know, stopped. Mercy was not in pain. Everything looked okay. Until in the evening around 5 p.m., around 5 p.m., Mercy woke up and vile tu alisimama akaniambia, I felt something strange. Nimesikia kitu inateremka kama mtoto anataka kutoka. There's something I hadn't said that I think was around 8 weeks. At 8 weeks, Mercy had done something called McDonald's stitch. McDonald's teach me in a panyango and a guidance. It's basically to
Alashika, ambia watu wanyamaze huko nyuma. Aya, kwa hiyo wake nai te wake tabanari kebo ugire banda ya ni amazi wake le duka edu yewo tabanari drama kwa heshima kebo ugire banda ya ni amazi tunaomba utupe that minute ugiwe umetulia tutambua waheshimiwa na bwana yake mazi amalinde na hindi mwengi mbume wakilikogio uwa za maraisi mbume wakilikogio uwa mwanoe asa maraisi.
So Dr. Saidana McDonald's teaching to protect the baby from coming out basically ni kufunga cervix kuzuia mtoto kushuka. So when Master told me amesikia like mtoto anashuka, nikamuuliza that's not possible because already we knew we had done that. As I was doubting, she told me, imagine nasikia mimi mwenyewe najisikia. So we didn't take chance, we went back to the hospital again. And true, mtoto alikuwa na sugar. By the time we went to the hospital, hata miguu ya mtoto ilikuwa nje. So the baby had ruptured the uterus. And in fact, hapo amepitia hata kwa cervix. So it was that serious. So kwa dakika nilipanga theater and doctors, so many doctors came in. They were coming in one after another, one after another. And they had to remove the baby and also the uterus. So it was painful. Mercy was very heartbroken when she got into the theater. And by the way, Mercy was walking by herself. She was talking, she was full of life. Only that things got complicated at the theater. And after the surgery, everything looked okay. And Mercy was supposed to be taken to the ICU. But before that could happen, Mercy got a cardiac arrest. And they tried to resuscitate her. But unfortunately, that is how Mercy left us. So I thought it was good to put that out there. And you see, people are wondering how people might be wondering how we are talking about having a bill in the hospital. That day alone, which was a marathon of about 12 hours, because Mercy spent 12 hours in theater, we got a big pain. There were many doctors, many specialists who came in to help the situation. Unfortunately, we had exhausted our insurance. As you know, when you're going in, inpatient gets exhausted. She had been admitted in January. So that is how we have a bill in the hospital. And that's why we were requesting for your help to clear the bill and also to give her a befitting send off. Otherwise, you will be able to Mercy would be very happy and wherever she is, if heavens her eyes, she can see how loved she is. Na kwa neasia akamba mwando mangubu, na ukamba ndika uma. Ukamba ndika uma. I came there and I became a member of you. So I feel as one of you. Na as much as Mercy hakujulikana sana kule kwetu Kikuyu, ni those who in one way or another came into contact with her feel the loss, because Mercy was warm, Mercy was a vibe, Mercy was so many things. So ne asante mono ekumunenga nda yesu mwe amuadime tuombe. Tumeachwa na mtoto, my daughter is 8 years old, so nituweke kwa maombi yenu na Mungu awabariki. Asante sana.
Thank you.